I'm Karthi Gopalan from Texas Instruments Silicon Valley. Let's talk about Internet of Things. So when we talk about Internet of Things, you think of different vectors such as pressure, temperature, air quality, right? Now, when it comes to any sensor systems, it takes months and months to develop these things. You end up having to select the right sensors, then you have to do the component selection, then you build the circuit, then you build the board, you have to then validate it, and then you prototype it. And if one vector is off, you have to start all over again. So we here at TI recognize this, and we want to make it as easy as possible for you to be able to hit the market as soon as possible. So we are all about making things easy. And today, I'm going to talk to you about a complete solution that gets you to market sooner. So out here in the slide deck, we have the wireless universal gas sensing platform overview. So we are talking about a gas sensor platform that hooks up with BLE. So this is intended as a reference design that you can use to develop end products to monitor oxygen and toxic gases like carbon monoxide, hydrogen sulfide, sulfur dioxide, phosphine, fluorine. There are a lot of different toxic gases out there. The BLE adds a wireless feature to the platform that enables seamless connectivity to an iPhone or an iPad. We can easily replace the targeted gas sensor based on their application while keeping the same sensor analog front end, AKA the LMP91000 and the BLE design CC2541. Let's talk about the target applications. So we are talking about safety, security, and environment monitoring. These are ubiquitous. You find them everywhere. We are talking about building automation, wherein it's the air quality, it's the productivity of the people, safety, mining industry, automotive cabin air quality, healthcare. We're talking about household carbon monoxide sensing. So this is just a few of the end applications. Now, we have a proven solution that's flexible and low power. We're talking about a solution that supports a wide variety of electrochemical gas sensors. Doesn't matter where it gets manufactured. If it's an electrochemical cell, our solution should be able to handle it. It's very modular. It can handle up to 30 plus gases. It has configurable interface. It supports various different protocols. The firmware and application software provided as open source is, this gives you an ability to hit the market as soon as possible. We are very ultra low power at 40 microamps max total power consumption. System runs off of a coin cell. Then you have the sensor analog front end. It's a complete solution. And of course, the BLE, which is low power and can support multiple data rates. The user interface, well, get onto the iTunes App Store. Look for TI gas sensor there. And let me jump right into the app. So out here on my iPad, I have the app ready to go. So here, if you click on the block diagram, you get the entire block diagram. The data sheet is right there at your fingertips, everything right there. You have the schematic. The whole schematic is provided for free. You have the bill of material captured. So let me jump right into the breadth analysis kit that I have here. So what we are doing right now is we are capturing the oxygen concentration in this part of the building. Right now, it's showing a healthy number of 20.8%. Let's see. I'm an athlete. Let's see if I have a good lung capacity. So I'm going to try to cut the oxygen supply. So I'm going to take a deep breath and then blow out carbon dioxide. So as you can see, I give up. So I brought the oxygen concentration down up to 18%. So someone out there, you might be able to blow more hot air than I do, but gives you an idea. This was a quick breath analyzer test wherein I was able to capture the various, you know, changes that happens with the oxygen concentration as I breathe out, right? So this is one. So now I have this other kit here that monitors carbon monoxide. So let us see if we are in a safe environment. So I have my iPhone here. Let me click on to the app and give this a second. Have that, and then you have the plot that's capturing the carbon monoxide concentration in this part of the building. Good news, it's less than one. It's basically showing 0.99 ppm. So we are in a very, you know, healthy environment. So we just did a quick demonstration of oxygen sensing and carbon monoxide. For additional information, please do visit ti.com/sensorAFE. Thank you very much.